Hello, leader. Great to see you again. And welcome back to our first tip in 5 tips to care for your crew. My last video, I did an introduction to this using Romans chapter 12, which was written by the Apostle Paul. And in chapter 12 of Romans, Paul encourages us as believers in Jesus to put ourselves on the altar figuratively as a sacrifice. And I talked about how leadership is a sacrifice. We're all called to lead. You are called to lead. You're called to lead those who are in your group, those who are in your family, those of you who are overseeing people at work or school. You're called to lead, and that's a sacrifice. And as a sacrifice, that sacrifice is caring. Leading is caring. Caring many times is leading. And when you are caring for people, it looks like this. It looks like weeping with those who weep and laughing with those who laugh. In our groups, we're going to have moments where it's going to be, there's tears. And there's going to be tears of joy, and many times there's going to be tears of pain. And leading is caring for those people. So how do we go about caring for people? 5 tips, and here's the first one. The first one is super simple, and you're going to say, oh, I already knew that. But are we doing it? The first one is time. It's the most valuable resource that you and I, we have, time. We have money enough to pay our bills, to get the things, the small things at least in life that we want, but time is limited, right? We only have 24 hours in a day. We only have 7 days a week. We only have so much time that we can give. It's super valuable. And we see that Jesus gave this resource away to those who were closest to him. He guarded it carefully for those 12 disciples, and he expanded it somewhat to a larger group, but mainly it was those 12 men, young men, who he gave his time to, 3 years, day in, day out, giving of his time. Well, we don't have 3 solid years to give away, morning, noon, and night, do we? No, we can't do that. But we can give away the time that we have. Many of you are leading a small group, and that means giving away one night a week or one night every other week. It's giving away that time, that hour, 2 hour, 3 hour time. For many of us, it's connecting with those people who are following us on Sunday mornings. It's giving away that time when we would rather maybe be connecting with this person over here, but we're going to connect with the people in our group. For some of you, it might be a monthly activity on top of these other meeting times that we have of giving that time away. What time are you giving, and are you fully invested in that time? Fully invested in the people that God has called you to lead during the time that you're meeting with them. And then the question is how do we give more time knowing that our time is limited? We only have so much to give. Well, here's an idea for you. What if you used your phone, your computer, as a way to connect with them in a short amount of time with a text thread? Hey, just saying, hey, I'm thinking about you. Here's a scripture that I've been reading and I've been meditating on. I just wanted to share with you, my group. Is there anything that I can be praying for you about? Now, some of us I know, we don't love to have our phones blowing up with all these different texts coming back and forth. So maybe it's just an individual text. Hey, there's only so many people in your group, right? So in your group, just saying with a one member or two members, hey, I've been thinking about you, praying for you. Here's something that I wanted to share with you. But using your phone, your computer, an email, sometimes a phone call, and using that time, that short way to connect with people in your group, giving of your time. Well, that's a tip. Here's a caution. The caution is simple. It's our time is valuable. And it's okay at times to say no. No, not now. But how about this time? And you have to know in your own life where the boundaries are. I'm not going to accept phone calls after 10 o'clock at night. I'm not going to return texts after this time frame. I know that Saturday mornings from this time to that time are valuable time to have with my family or to have my own time to regenerate, recharge, and that's okay. You need that time. In fact, we see Jesus did that. He got away onto the mountainside to get away and say, no, not now. But he would come down and he would give that time back to the people. What is it that you need to value in your life? What time, what boundaries do you need to set? Well, let me encourage you, whatever those boundaries are, they're okay. But ultimately what we're doing is we're caring for people, right? We're doing what Paul tells us to do. We're putting ourselves on the altar. We're giving our way ourselves. We're caring for people by leading them, and we're leading people by caring for them, and we're giving our time away. That's how we care for our crew. Well, thanks for watching this video, and look forward to seeing you here in a couple of weeks.